It made cool power.
What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to another installment of us probably breaking stuff on our E36, but hopefully not today. And I say this because today we are going to be taking the car to the dyno. We're going to an event there, and we've kind of decided, well, we don't actually know how many ponies we've lost over the years. So we're going to stick her on the dyno, see what she can do. We know it's running a bit rough, so we know there's a bit of a fueling issue. We think it might be the mass airflow sensor. We're not 100% sure, but we want to get a bit of a baseline and see what she's making now. So then we can see how far we've progressed once we start doing a couple more mods to the car, start getting other things right. But for this video, we're going to start letting you guys in on a little bit of the plan. So first things first, we got AMS 3D from Centurion in, and they helped us scan the car. We are going to be scanning this car and all the body panels because we've got some pretty big modifications that we want to make. And in order to do those, we need to be able to have an accurate CAD model. Between myself and Jaco, we are pretty proficient on various CAD softwares. So as you saw in last week's video, we're going to be using the same CAD skills that we used to create our radiator clips to create some awesome modifications for this vehicle. So we're going to give you guys a quick sneak peek of that right now.
Hi guys, I'm Vaughn, work at AMS 3D, and today I'm here at Clutch Culture to 3D scan an E36 323i.
So guys, as Vaughn said, he's from AMS 3D. They've been kind enough to come and scan our car for us, and we can't tell them too much of why we're scanning the car right now. All you need to know is that we need to be able to have a full CAD model of this car so that we can do some really cool stuff. Vaughn has explained to us how it all works now. So we have scanned most of the car. We've still got this corner to basically do. After we've done that, we can let the software sketch and stitch the whole thing together, and then we'll have a CAD model that we can hopefully figure out. But myself and Jaco, we can hopefully figure out how to manipulate it to be able to do what we need to do. So the first step for us to be able to 3D scan the car is to assess the surface. Now in the case of our car, we came to the conclusion that the surfaces were way too shiny with way too many transparent surfaces. So what we do in a situation like this is use developer spray, or in our case, dry shampoo, to mattify the surface. Not only does this mattify the surface, but it provides the scanner with geometry in order for it to be able to read where it is. In the case of a car where there are lots of flat, repetitive surfaces, the scanner itself can sometimes find it a little bit difficult to scan the vehicle. It's effectively the same as being lost in the woods and seeing a mountain that you recognize to get your bearings. Once that is out the way, we turn off all the lights so that the scanner can more accurately read the surface of the vehicle. This allows the scanner to project its own white light and be able to read this light without any other interference from any other light source. We slowly make our way around the car, and the computer which the scanner is hooked up to will then start piecing the pieces together. And once Vaughn is completely done with the scan, he'll be able to sit and align everything so that it all fits snugly and can start generating us a full 3D CAD model. So that's just a quick snippet of us 3D scanning the car. You guys are gonna have to stay tuned. Make sure you smash that subscribe button, hit the like button, share it with your friends. And if you don't wanna miss the next episode where we dive a little bit deeper into scanning the car and what our plans with those scans are, make sure you hit the notification bell, because that way you won't miss a single upload. All right guys, so we are on our way to the dyno day. It looks like it's going to be quite well attended, so we have decided that we're definitely going to be sticking the E36 on the dyno. We really do want to get a bit of a baseline and see what we're working with. We do think there's a little bit of an issue with the mass airflow sensors. The car is running a little bit rich, so we're not too worried about hurting the engine, but if we do, this video just got a lot more interesting, and we've made a lot more work for ourselves too in the process. What's your bet on the power?
80. I think 80 will be a good number.
Yeah, so guys, 125 at the flywheel standard, but that was 26 years ago. So we're banking on losses, obviously, through the drivetrain. And then on top of that as well, it's old. So we're thinking probably around, what do you reckon? I'm going to give a specific number of 86.
86. Okay, I'm going to go 81.
Okay, 81. Let's see. Thank you.
good to know.
I mean, it's exactly what we expected, so that's cool. But we were like, we know it's running a ridge, but we wanted to see where we're at.
Hey? MS meter.
That's exactly what I said. Because they're a common problem on these, though.
Very common.
Very common problem. So that's the thing. We knew that something wasn't right, but we know it's fueling.
Yeah.
So now it's a case of, cool. Now we can fix it and then see what your action makes afterwards.
Right, so as you guys saw there, we've got our dyno figures. We've definitely lost a couple ponies over the years. Jen, what did you think of how much power it was making?
It's a little disappointing.
Jen's first reaction was, my Figo makes 88, so we had to remind her that that was the flywheel, but they're probably pretty closely matched. So guys, we've got a bit of work to do there to squeeze a couple more horses out of the stable, but that's also fine. This is a learning process. We enjoy working on our car, so now we know that we've got a bit more work, and we know that the rewards on the other side of doing all that work will be well worth all of this. So guys, we're heading back to the garage now, and we're going to start fiddling around with some of the interior trim. So Jaco and myself now are going to be diving into the car. There's a couple little bits of trim and some just niggly little bits and pieces that have been really bothering us. The hood liner at some point was refurbished in black, but the actual sun visors, the lights, and things like these handle blanks, and even the actual handles are all gray. And you can see that the previous owner tried to paint these black. So we're gonna try and do a better job at doing this so that everything is nicely blacked out. I'm sorry that I didn't hit you back when you called my line. Who did you even need to talk? Are you wasting time declining all your FaceTime calls? Cause you're not my vibe, oh God, just let me go to sleep. Someone get high with me. Yeah, cause I'm running, I'm running, I'm running away. I'm running away, running away. I'm looking, I'm looking, I'm looking for space. I'm looking for space, looking for space. I'm healing, I'm healing from all of the pain. All of the pain, all of the pain. I'm running, I'm running, I'm running away. I've already given this a bit of a wipe. It was pretty much that color. It is now like PlayStation 1 gray. This gray piece here seems to have been glued to the clear outer skin. So we were hoping that was two separate pieces, because the plan was to take the gray piece off, paint it black, and pop it back in. But I don't think that's going to be a possibility. So we're going to try and see if we can just mask up around here and in here. And then what we'll do with that is we will then use Plasti-Dip to Plasti-Dip this black. And if it looks bad, well, it's Plasti-Dip, so we can always peel it off. Right, guys, so what I've done here is I've masked up this whole thing, and I'm using this light now to kind of see this profile around here. So I'm using the light to shine through here so I can then go and basically then stencil out this whole profile here so that we can paint around it, but not paint where the light needs to come out. Guys, I've got the binoculars on here because I've been doing some intricate work. You can see we've now got it all sprayed up. This lens here looked a lot like this lens, and all I've done is gone and run a blade right around the edges, lifted an edge, and then pulled it all back. And because it's plastied up, you can kind of pull it off in one piece. So it is not perfect, but I think it's a vast improvement from this gray to go to the black. So we'll get it back on the car just now and see how it looks. What makes you guys think that it's taken a couple of attempts to get this thing masked off? I am covered in masking tape and it is just absolutely everywhere. Right guys, so the Plasti-Dip is dry, and we're going to get it back on here and we're going to get a first look and see how it's going to look.
That was satisfying.
Right everyone, we've got this back in now, and in my very, very humble opinion, this looks way better now that it's blacked out and it matches the roof liner. So yeah, I think that is a win. We can't test these because the car needs to be on for those to work. But I think that looks way better. The old grey one just really broke up that look. So now I think if we can get the sun visors back in and black, and the side pieces and the handles back in, and it's all black, I think it's gonna look better. What do you think?
A lot better.
Yeah,
that already looks a lot better.
It's just made the car look a lot younger already.
Yes.
Oh. So I think we're on the right track here, everyone. So yeah, one down, quite a few bits to go, but it's gonna be worth it.
Peeling the stuff off the light.
Sorry.
Good.
Minute.
So, how was today?
Well, we stuck the car on the dyno.
No.
It made fuck all power.
Not a lot. It's pretty much a Taz.
So we know we've got a fuel issue. Secondly, the second event that we wanted to go to was rained out. Thirdly, we've now got broken clips all over the place because 26-year-old plastic doesn't like being moved. But we've now got beautiful black
trim
handles, black trim back there, the black lights in the front, so that's beautiful. What else did we get done?
Yeah.
We found some parts on the internet that we want to buy. So we're going to buy those. So buy some shirts so we can buy some parts off the internet. But yeah, everyone, so we were hoping this episode would be full circle where we got all of our trim and everything sorted out. But we're going to have to sort that out and sort that one out. So we've got lots of broken clips to sort out. So that's not going to be done tonight because it is now currently 12:05. So that's probably going to be a tomorrow issue, maybe. So we're going to get going on that. But in the meantime, guys, we are hoping to get further along with the 3D scan and what we're wanting to do with the 3D scan. So make sure you're subscribed and make sure you've hit the notification bell because things are going to start ramping up quickly. These little niggly things we are hoping to get all out of the way. So we are sorry for taking so long on doing these small little things. We're trying to get them all out the way so that when it comes to the big stuff, we can fully commit to doing big stuff. So share this video with your friends. Get yourself an entry to win the car by heading over to clutchculture.co.za. Every 20 rand you spend there will get you one entry into winning the car. The draw is on the 30th of September, so make sure you get your entries in soon because before you know it, this car is going to be given away to one of you guys. So we're going to try and fix some more things. You'll only see that next week, so make sure you tune in next week.